To to our local communities. Also thrilled with all the city councilors that are here, and to have Tom Tracy, the acting town manager, be here with us is just really incredible. And also to be joined by Greg St. Louis, the superintendent of Watertown's DPW. Just 11 months ago, Congress, in partnership with the White House, enacted the American Rescue Plan. And this historic relief bill meets the moment that we still find ourselves in. It delivered free vaccines, the largest tax cut to working families in U.S. history, lower health costs, economic support for struggling small businesses and restaurants, and much, much more. And it has paved the way for the economic recovery that we are experiencing. 6.6 million jobs created, under 4% unemployment, and higher wages for workers. We are seeing the benefits of this law each and every day across the Commonwealth and across the country, including right here in Watertown. Using the American Rescue Plan funding, Watertown is removing dangerous lead pipes and improving stormwater infrastructure. In turn, we are improving the quality of drinking water and the quality of life for our residents. We have long known the danger of lead pipes and the climate and financial risks of disregarding our infrastructure needs. With these investments, we are on the right course and putting people and our planet first. That's not all. We know that the best policy comes from listening to our local partners. You and your community know what work needs to be done to improve lives and build a stronger, more sustainable tomorrow. This funding is a direct result between the partnership of federal, state, and local government, and government listening, seeing, and acting on the needs of our residents. In fact, the American Rescue Plan, the Democrats passed into law, the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act, will also eliminate lead pipes across America and ensure that every household, school, and child care center has clean, safe drinking water. It is the largest investment in water infrastructure in American history and will provide over $1 billion to Massachusetts alone. I'm thrilled to be here to celebrate these vital community improvements and to thank my hardworking partners in Watertown government who are bringing these investments to life for Watertown residents. I want to end with this. I know there is more work to be done as we recover and rebuild. But just as we brought relief funding and infrastructure investments in Massachusetts, I'm committed to advancing an agenda that continues to create jobs, lower costs, and ensure that every single American has a shot at success. Thank you for being here today. We look forward to this project in the next year. Introduce my incredible partner in the State Senate, and honored to call him a personal friend, State Senator Bill Brownsburger.
So I think it's worth underlining or recognizing the extent to which this really does begin at the top in one sense. Katherine Clark has not only been a very effective member of Congress, but she's been a very effective leader helping elect members of Congress who would deliver the kind of relief that we see in these two major federal packages. So without Catherine's effort, it's realistic to say that perhaps we wouldn't have these enormous benefits for the nation and the Commonwealth of Massachusetts and for people trying to get by all across the country. So I'm extremely grateful for Catherine's leadership on so many levels. I think it's worth underlining, as my friend and really esteemed colleagues, Steve Owens, underlined the breadth of this collection of relief measures. It really is very broad. So many different good things are happening across state government and local government as a result of the federal intervention. And of course, a huge federal intervention directly into the pockets of so many households across the country that kept people afloat through the difficult, most difficult months of COVID, which of course are not over. But what I want to end by is lift up something that Katherine said, which is this is all about partnerships. Why is this happening? Because our DPW director said, this is what we need. And so we knew what to do. Nothing happens without the local leadership, which we're so grateful for. Greg St. Louis is a very effective DPW director, and I'm grateful for his work on this and Mount Auburn Street project and so many other things that are happening in Watertown. So it starts at the top, but it takes everybody. And I look out at all the members of the city council, the acting town manager, and just know that we're all one big team. And the only way things get done is that way, as we are working as a team. And so I'm so grateful and pleased to introduce our DPW director, Greg St. Louis.
Thank you. And thank you to all our delegates. Much appreciated. Certainly, as we focus on infrastructure sustainability, planning for the future comes paramount. And implement any of these projects without the funding being provided to various departments in the city. DPW and planning work together to identify a couple of these projects. Thankfully, we received $250,000 towards stormwater infrastructure and localized flooding. One of the areas that's shown on the graph to my left is a section of the rail trail that connects Alewife to Charles River and Cambridge to Watertown. Fixing this flooding helps address some of our nutrient problems in the Charles River, as well as keeping stormwater in the ground. Second project is our lead service pipe replacement program. We work very closely with the MWRA and MassDEP in replacing our lead pipes. This money goes directly into replacing water infrastructure that serves our very thankful.
Our presentation, we'll be taking a few questions.
Why are store shelves so empty?
We're in the middle of a global pandemic that's causing inflation to rise, and that's exactly why our priority is lowering costs for the American people. It started with the American Rescue Plan, Democrats followed up with the Infrastructure Act, and just a few weeks ago passed the Competes Act. That's how we rebuild our domestic manufacturing. That's how we protect our supply chain for the future. That's how we lower costs and meet the challenges that people are feeling at the grocery store, at the gas pump, with their heating bills.
Thank you so much, everybody.